So, hello everyone, myself Venu, working as a lecturer in mechanical engineering from Government Polytechnic Warangal. So our subject regarding the refrigeration and air conditioning, and today's topic video session on mixing of air streams and some numerical problems regarding there is mixing of air streams and some psychrometric problems also. So if you see the last previous video sessions, so mostly we have concentrated on the psychrometry. So seen a lot of topics regarding that, some terminology of psychrometry, psychrometric processes, and some numerical problems on that. So till the last class we have what we have seen, and in today's class we will see a new topic, what happens when different air streams are mixed, to which that air stream has to be passed to the air conditioner, what are the changes taken place in that, and regarding how to solve that numerical problems, all the cases we will see in this today's video session. And so just we'll recall what is the last class, what we have focused on. So mostly we have seen the psychrometric processes. So hope you have remembered these topics, like different processes on humidification, dehumidification, cooling and dehumidification, heating and dehumidification, cooling with the adiabatic humidification. So all these topics we have discussed in the last previous video session. And coming to today's objective, so hope you will understood what happened when the mixing of air streams are taken place. So what is the mixing of air streams and how to solve the various numerical problems regarding on that particular topic. So all these things we will study in this today's topic. So just a few things like objectives or the what are the air streams, and what happens when air streams are mixed, different air streams like the written air or some fresh air or conditioned air, when some of the air will not make contact with that cooling apparatus, and they may bypass with and mix at some other places. So mixing of different air streams will take place. Under that case, what is happened? And next objective is how to solve problems on mixing of air and mixing of air streams and some psychrometric processes. So we'll see all these objectives in today's video class. So moving on to the mixing of the air streams. So in this, to analyze what we are doing, different passages or two different passages we are considering, two different pipelines, and in which both the air streams are passed through the different sections, and both of the air streams are mixing with the in the same pipeline. So they are passing in the same duct. Consider two ducts where it is getting mixed at as a one stream and passing through a one duct. So let us see the diagram of that. Before that, we will see some points regarding that. So mixing of air streams means in air conditioning applications, the written air is mixed with the fresh air. So as we have discussed that, written air, whatever the already used air within the conditioned room, so that is named as written air, that is mixed with the fresh air in the conditioned apparatus. So within the apparatus it is getting mixed. So both of them are having the different properties. They are moving in two different streams, and what happened, two different different properties are gained by those two different streams, like in two different streams of air having different properties are mixed together, how without changing the enthalpy and moisture content. Okay, so without changing enthalpy and moisture content, so how the different properties are obtained in this. So now you can get some idea regarding this, how the two different air streams are mixing in a single duct or in a moving in a one air stream. So you can see this process, and that mixing of air streams are represented on the psychrometric chart also. So what are the different, so you can see here First we will see how you are taking that. So two different ducts, so where consider some fresh air is moving and return air is moving in other other duct, two different ducts. So both are having the different the properties of the air, like the mass of air coming through that first passage and second passage may be different. They will be mentioned as the mass of air per minute which is carrying in the pipe. It may be m1 m2, and similarly the specific humidity value may be changes to w1 and w2. Enthalpy value will be different, like h1 and h2 in two different streams. So both are them mixing and moving in a one stream or in a one duct here. So where it is maintaining the mixing together, and properties are taking it as a mass of the air moving or which is passing in the stream per minute, taken as m3, and w3 is that is a specific humidity value of that mixed air, and h3 is the final enthalpy value what after mixing the both the air streams. So this is how we can represent it here. This process 1 to 2, complete process 1 to 2. So we'll explain what is these points 1, 2, and 3. So accordingly we have noted the points of a specific humidity, that is w1, w2 and w3. Similarly, the on the x-axis we can represent the dry bulb temperature values like td1, td2 and td3 with reference to the points noted on the this psychrometry process on the chart. So accordingly we have noted the enthalpy values also, h1, h2 and h3. So we will see what is happening regarding this. So kindly make a note of this chart and try to remember this, the mixing of air streams diagram. Now let us see a few things. Now the psychrometric properties of the mixture can be calculated. How the calculation? By balancing the masses and energy terms. Like masses in the sense, those coming, the air stream which is coming with the different masses, m1, m2, both are mixing together and forming the masses, m3. So you can consider addition, we'll see the points m1 plus m2 equal to m3. It means we are balancing the mass. Okay, m1 plus m2 equal to m3, like I will see here. So m1 is the mass of the air stream per minute. It is coming through the first section, and m2 is coming through the second section. So combination of or addition of m1 plus m2 masses, so which is equal to the final mass, that is the m3. Okay. Now for energy, for energy in terms of energy, in terms of is moisture or in specific humidity, we can write that as point m1 w1 plus m2 w2, so which is equal to m3 w3. So you can write the terms in terms of energy. So you can write the same formula, same value as m1 h1 plus m2 h2 equal to m3 h3. So in place of m3 we can substitute the value here, that m3 equal to m1 plus m2. So three equations we have noted, that is m1 plus m2 equal to m3 is the first. Second equation in terms of moisture content, that is m1 w1 plus m2 w2 equal to m3 w3. And in terms of energy, the equation, energy equation can be written like this, m1 h1 plus m2 h2 equal to m3 h3. So using all these three cases, so now we can further simplify this formula in terms of moisture content, where it can be written as m1 into w1 minus w3. So by substituting these values, all values, finally you can write, bring these common terms, m1 w1 at the left side, and at the right side you can see it is a here, this is m1 w1 is the. So now if you are multiplying this value here, that it will become m1 w3. So now bring this m1 w3 to the left hand side. So common term, it is m1 here, this m1. So m1, if you take common, then it can be written as m1 into w1 minus w3. Similarly, at this side, you bring this m2 w2 to the right hand side. So taking the common term m2 to this side, so now it can be written as m2 into so w3 minus w2. Okay. So finally, you can write the ratio between the two masses, that is m1 by m2 equal to, so you are bringing this m2 to this denominator to the left hand side, and it will become denominator. So m1 by m2 equal to w3 minus w2 by this w1 minus w3 will be brought to the right hand side to the denominator, which is equal to w3 minus w2 by w1 minus w3. This is a masses ratio of the two masses which is passing in two different air streams. So now the formula, if you substitute again, you can get in terms of the energy equation. So how it can be written? So this in terms of specific humidity values, the same formula can be written in terms of the, we can find the W3 value by using the form. Same can be repeated here from this second equation, where W3, which is equal to, we can write like this, M1 W1 plus M2 W2. So, this bottom one, M1 W1 plus M2 W2 by M1 plus M2. From the this second equation, we have got this to find the what is the W3 value here. And similarly, we will see the formula in terms of the energy equation. So this is a diagram already we have seen, and here this is the formula in terms of energy. The same formula what we have solved like this in terms of moisture content or in terms of specific humidity, same formula can be written in terms of the this enthalpy also. That is M1 by M2 equal to H3 minus H2 by H1 minus H3. Please try to remember this formula in terms of specific humidity and in terms of enthalpy here. In terms ratios between the two masses, M1 by M2 equal to H3 minus H2 by H1 minus H3. So finally, we can also find the H3 value, very similar to what we have seen before. The formula, we have found the what is the W3 by using all these conditions. Similarly, we can write the H3 also. So that is equal to M1 H1 plus M2 H2 by, this is the energy equation, by M1 plus M2. This M1 plus M2 is nothing but it is equal to M3. We are bringing this side, and H3 will be put at this side and bringing M3 to the downwards. Now M3 is nothing but M1 plus M2 we are writing here. So this is how we can find the H3 value. Now, so thus, here you can see the sentence. The point 3 divides the line 1, 2 in the inverse ratio of the mixing masses. Okay. So this is how, what are the different formulas regarding the mixing of air streams. So how you can find the final condition of the properties, like how to find the M3 value, and how to find the W3, and how to find the H3. So three different properties we are finding out the exit after mixing of the air streams. How to find the M3, how to find the W3 specific humidity, and how to find the H3. Okay. Let us see some few problems regarding all these cases. So this is the problem. Please try to note, just read out this problem, and you can note it down, and we will see it further. Hope you got how to solve it. So what are the given data here? Just we'll see one by one. Right, so first here they are given the fresh air, which is one stream of air which is coming with a rate or at a rate of 100 meter cube per minute from the environment, with a dry bulb temperature 40 degree centigrade and wet bulb temperature is 27 degree centigrade, is mixed with the other air, that is fresh air, along with the retained air it is mixing. So the retained air is coming with a 600 meter cube per minute from the room. It is that retained air is coming back with a dry bulb temperature 23 degree centigrade and relative humidity 50%. So now what they are asking to calculate dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, specific humidity of the mixture. That means the final W3 value. How to find the W3? So already we have seen that formula, and from that so you have to know some values regarding in that formula, then you can find out very easy. Okay, so just the same problem when it is presented on psychrometry chart. First we will see these streams. Already we have seen the diagram. One pressure is coming through one and through the second duct, the return air is coming, and both of them are mixing at this third section, but as a single stream it is forming. The same can be represented here in a psychrometric chart. Mixing of air streams are taking place, and so this can be plotted. If you have found out the values, so this it can be plotted here, but meanwhile you will get the same case here as what we are seeing here. That 0.1, 2 process, and what, and 3, the 0.3 also. So here, due to mixing, the value may be reached. It came within the line here. So before the 0.2, then you are getting this condition. So the how the process can be mentioned here. Points you can locate it here according to that the reference points here mentioned, like 1, 2 and 3, so where the properties located on the points, so you can note it down here, W1, W2 and W3, and similarly enthalpy values and dry-bulb temperature values on the x-axis. So we will see here how we can plot this. And here first what we are doing, locate the 0.1 on the psychrometric chart corresponding to the dry bulb temperature. So from the given data what they are mentioned in the problem, from that value first you try to mention the DBT 40 degree centigrade on the x-axis here, so at this point, and wet bulb temperature line will be drawn, a slanted vertical line you can see here, which is at 27 degree centigrade. So we'll locate the point here as a 0.1. similarly, mark 0.2 on the chart, so here, which indicates the dry bulb temperature 23 degree centigrade, and a value of RH curve will be there, so which is 50%. So two points are located here by from the given data which is given in the problem. So further we can find out the remaining values, and so this is how we have plotted the line. Next, continuation. So what you have to do, first you have to join the line 1, 2, 2 with a, on the chart you can just roughly draw a line, just invisible line you can draw there, and 0.3 indicates the condition of the resulting mixture, which lies on the line 1 and 2, the point 1 and 2 line, in the inverse ratio of the mixing masses. So we'll see the how you are getting that point. You can see it. So first, we are getting that what is the m1 value mass. So from the given value, from the 0.1, so the v1, just we have taken that as 100 from the given data, and the specific volume lines are there. So at the 0.1 the value can be noted as 0.993. so kindly look into the your the psychrometric chart, then you can look at the specific volume point as at 0.1 as 0.913. So from that we can find the m1 value as 109.53 kg per minute. So this is the second point you can see here, and that specific volume line at 0.1 is 0.913. similarly we can find the m2. So from the given the total volume as 600 meter cube per minute, and specific volume at 0.2 can be noted from the chart. Just kindly try to find that the specific volume line, and see what is the exact value. Mostly it may be 0.852 at 0.2. so total mass of air stream is passing through that section is 705 kgs per minute. This is approximate, and m1 value is 109. So maybe fresh air is 109, return air you can take it as 705. Now so the ratio of the masses can be noted here. We have the formula in terms of at specific humidity, m1 by m2 equal to, so W3 minus W2 by W1 minus W3. This is how we can find out. So from psychrometry chart, so we have to locate those points, W1, W2, so all those points we have to get there. So at 0.1, If you draw a horizontal line from the point 1 towards the y ordinate, which is at the right hand side, so then you can plot that the W1 value as 0.0175 kg kilojoules kg per kg of dry air. Similarly, at point 2, what is the W2 value? That is 0.009 kg per kg of dry air. Now, from equation 1, so we can substitute here. We know this M1 by M2 value, so which is equal to W3 minus, we got W1 and W2. So unknown values here, W3. So from that, we can find what is the W3 value. So this is the specific humidity at point 3. For getting this value, W3 equal to 0.0102 kg per kg of dry air. So we have got one factor, that is a W3. Now, you got here how we can locate the point here on the y ordinate of specific humidity. What were the value I got for W3? So locate on the y ordinate here, then according to that you can draw a straight horizontal line which is coinciding this slanting this is a slanted line. So now you can locate the point 3 at this side. So from that you can draw so whatever we have drawn the horizontal line through W3 till it intersect the line 1 2. So mark the point as 3. So from that point 3, so you can extend the WBT line towards upward, where you can find all the point of where you can find the enthalpy H3 value. So at point 3, if you extend the line towards to the downwards, so what is here, if you draw this line, you can get the what is the H3 value. Similarly, if you draw towards x axis, you can get the dry bulb temperature value and the noted dry bulb temperature. So from the chart can be recorded here is, that is at 25.5 degrees centigrade. Similarly, the WT value, wet bulb temperature line, so the line which are passing, we can see the WBT lines in the chart. So this is how we are drawing the WBT lines in this way. So the temperature recorded is 18.2 degrees centigrade. So you got the two values here, and where first of all you are finding out the W3 value or drawing a horizontal straight line and a horizontal vertical line from the point 3. There you can recording the what is the DBT and what is the WBT. Okay, and next we will move into the, so this is how we are finding out the values very easily. If you have understood, it's very easy. Okay, so you can practice on the chart for number of times, then you can easily do it for any kind of problems. Now the next, but you have to remember what type of problem it is. So what type of problem we are focusing, either it is the mathematical form, how to find the psychrometric process, the psychrometric the terminology by using mathematical conditions, or the psychrometry by using finding out thermodynamic properties of air by using this chart, or it is a psychrometric process problems, or it is a mixing of air stream problems. So all these things you have to analyze and you have to solve the problems. It's very simple to identify. Next, we move into the next problem. Just for a while, you see the this is the second problem. For a while, you read this question, and we'll move into the solution part. Just you can note it down the problem. We'll see the number of problems today, and we can complete this chapter. So for meanwhile, you can see that. So given question is atmospheric condition of air specified by dry bulb temperature 30 degrees centigrade, humidity ratio is mentioned here, that is 15 grams per per kg of dryer. Generally you are mentioning kg per kg of dryer, so then you can get 15 grams, convert that into a kg per kg of dryer. And it's your possibility, so easiness, how you can find out that on the psychrometric chart point. So determine partial vapor pressure, that is the PV, partial vapor pressure, and relative humidity, RH value, at that particular point. Okay, so this is a solution. Variable given data is mentioned here. So here the saturated pressure at 30 degree centigrade, so which is equal to, in terms of mm of Hg, the value is 31.82. Dry bulb temperature is 30 degree centigrade. The humidity ratio, so W equal 15 grams per kg of dryer, where it can be converted, if you do by 1000, so which is equal to 0.015 kg per kg of dryer. That is the W value, you can look at on the chart. Now, barometric pressure, so which is equal to 760 mm of Hg. That is the PB value. PS value at 30 degree centigrade is 31.82 mm of Hg. Then we can find what is the partial pressure, partial vapor pressure, PV value. So hope you have remembered this formula, where W equal to 0.622 into PV by PB minus PV. So PB is a barometric pressure. So you know the W value is given in the data, 0.015, 0.622 is the standard, into PV by 760 minus PV. So from this, if you do the simplification, this is how you can simplify. And further, we can find what is the PV value. So vapor pressure, so which is equal to, mostly we are getting 17.89 mm of Hg. To do the simplification process, you can note down the steps here. So partial pressure, vapor pressure equal to 17.89 mm of Hg. And very simply, you can find the relative humidity by using the formula. Okay, right. So this is how you are getting that phi equal to the PV by PS. PV by PS. I remember this formula. Okay. So partial vapor pressure equals 17.89, and saturation pressure at the particular dryable temperature is 31.82. So relative humidity in terms of percentage you are mentioning. So phi value you are getting it as 56.2%. Okay. Right. So here is some note it has given that, for given set of condition, dry bulb temperature 30 and that specific humidity value is mentioned, 0.015 kg. So relative humidity may also be obtained from the psychrometry chart. So as we have seen primarily in the initial stage of the problem, I told that if you know these two factors, any two factors, so we can find the other factor also. So whatever the asked one is the relative humidity, so then it can be obtained from the psychrometric chart directly, or you can do with this formula also. Why? Because we are finding out the partial vapor pressure, and we know the saturation pressure at that particular temperature, then we can find the relative humidity value phi by using this mathematical formula, phi equal to PV by PS. Okay, so check the answer by with the help of psychrometric chart also, cross check the answer. So approximately you are getting that some 56 or 57%. This is a very simple and another model of a problem. And moving to the next one, there is a slight, again, we are representing the processes on psychrometric chart, the same formula, same problem again. Here, the humid air at 25 degree centigrade DBT and 30% relative humidity, having moisture content of 6 grams, that is a W value, specific humidity, 6 grams per kg of air, is humidified without change in the temperature. So humidification process taking place without change in temperature by increasing the moisture content. So humidification process by increasing the moisture content to 12 grams per kg of air. So 6 to 12, so W1, where the humidification process taking place. So in this process, they are asking from the chart to find the wet bulb temperature, that is a WBT, relative humidity, and enthalpy. So while reading this problem, and you have to make analysis in the background, how the lines can be drawn in the chart for the wet bulb temperature, and how the relative humidity will be there, how the curves will be drawn, where the enthalpy has to be plotted, it may be above the saturation or 100% relative humidity line, the enthalpy scale will be there. So you have to remember all those lines, then you can move into the solving this problem. Just we see the initial conditions. Like dry bulb temperature is at 25 and phi value is given, that is initial relative humidity value is 30%, and W1 is mentioned as 0.006, that 6 grams or 0.006 kg per kg of air. Similarly, final conditions they have mentioned regarding that W2 value 0.012 kg of air. So asking to find WBT, phi2 and H2, the final conditions, relative humidity, enthalpy value and WBT value. So this is how, just you can see here, we are drawing the psychrometric chart, a shoe type of structure. As we know that on the x-axis we are noting that as a dry bulb temperature, on the y-axis we are noting as specific humidity. Okay, so as we have got these two points as from the given data, so we can locate on the chart that W1 equal to 0.006, W2 equal to 0.012. So how the process can be done? So without changing the temperature, there is increase in the moisture content. So a straight vertical line can be drawn here where the dry bulb temperature is constant here, TD1 equal to TD2. Okay, now a WBT line, you can see this point 2 is located with the reference of this. Here you can see, here you are getting the what is the relative humidity at the final stage condition. This is one thing what we have to know, that is a 60% where the curve is passing. Here you can locate in the chart. If you have the chart, please go with that reference. And similarly, this is a WBT line, wet bulb temperature. After locating the point on the extending this line, locating on the saturation curve, there you can record what is the WBT dry wet bulb temperature, that is the TW2 value is 19.6 degree centigrade. In further extension of this line on the enthalpy scale, you can record the enthalpy value as so it may be given as H2 equal to 62. Okay, right. So just we'll see in how the process is done. So locate initial condition at point 1, so which is the intersection point of the vertical line representing the 25 degree centigrade. So this how the point is located. Point 1 means so the dry bulb temperature is taken on the x-axis, on the y-axis W1 value is noted on the y-axis. So intersection of these lines, horizontal and vertical line, intersection of this point is taken as 1. Okay, where the points are already known here for W1 and for TD1, already given in the data. After locating that point 1, so draw a vertical line until it intersects the horizontal line representing the moisture content, 0.012 kg per kg of air. So whatever the second line is there, second point here on the y-axis, so through this draw a horizontal line. So after drawing this, if you extend this point 1 line towards upwards, there is an intersection point you are getting here 2. So that point can be noted as point 2. So from that chart you can record what is the wet bulb temperature, that what you are 19.6, and phi2 value is 60%, enthalpy value is 62 kilojoules per kg of dry air. So very simple problem. So you have to know what is the process we are used, that is a humidification process, and how to draw that process in the chart, how to locate the points in the chart, that is very important. Okay, the next, 150 cubic meter of air per minute is required to be cooled from 35 degree centigrade DBT and 55% RH to 25 degree centigrade DBT and 50% RH. So determine the capacity of the refrigerating machines. So here are there some given conditions. Initial conditions are 35 degree centigrade TD1, phi1 equal to 55%. And final condition is TD2 equal to 25 degree centigrade and phi2 equal to 50%. So at 35 degree centigrade, what is the specific volume? 0.9 meter cube per kg. So you can get this answer or get this value from the psychrometric chart. So practice from the psychrometric chart, you can record the value. Next, So mass of air cooled, same value can be taken. If you know the volumes, it is a total volume by a given specific volume at that particular temperature at that particular point. So V by Vs1. So 150 cubic meter of air per minute is taken as total volume by specific volume at that particular point is 0.9. So total mass of air circulated is 166.67 kg per minute. Per minute calculation you are taking. So mass of air cooled in that. Now using the chart here, so at 25 degree centigrade and 50% RH. So locating 35 degree centigrade, this is the first initial point. 35 degree centigrade and relative humidity is 55%. So if you know this point, so there you can record what is the enthalpy value, 85.9 kilojoules per kg. And H2 value is 50 kilojoules per kg. Now heat rejected can be taken as the mass of air circulated, what we have taken there, so 166.67 we have got there kg per minute. And enthalpy value you can record from the known given data. We are finding out from the chart, that is the H1, what is the H1 and what is the H2 value, 85 and 50. So you are substituting here. So finally the heat rejected can be taken as 5983.45 kilojoules per minute. So capacity of the refrigerating machine, so this 2 ton is a for a 1 ton refrigerating machine, the heat whatever the capacity of the machine in terms of kilojoules per minute, it is equal to 1 ton for 1 ton machine, which is equal to, it is 210 kilojoules per minute. So total heat rejected is 5983.45. If you are taking, if you want the capacity of refrigerating machine in ton, so you are doing by 210. For 1 ton it is a 210 capacity, but total this much of heat rejection, 5983.45, what is, how much of tonnage of capacity of refrigerating machine is required? If you do the total heat rejected by this for 1 ton heat rejection process, 210, so total tonnage of capacity machine required is 28.49 ton. So this is how you are calculating. So in terms of kilowatts, you do by 60, means in kilowatts, kilojoules per second, nothing but kilojoules per second or kilowatts, you do by 60, then you can get the same value in 99.72 kilojoules per second or 99.72 kilowatts. Okay. The next problem, 175 meter cube of air, just read for some while, we'll get back again. Hope you have understood the problem. We move into the solution part. Just we go through the problem 5 here, fifth problem. There is a, the volume is given as 175 meter cube of air per minute passes through adiabatic humidifier. Remember this point, adiabatic humidifier. So the condition of air at inlet is 40 degree centigrade DBT and 15% RH. Outlet condition is also mentioned. It is at 25 degree centigrade dry bulb temperature and at 20 degree centigrade wet bulb temperature. Vapor added to air per minute. Okay. Now, writing all these given data here, the volume of air circulated is 175 meter cube per minute. So inlet conditions are mentioned and outlet conditions are mentioned. So we can note it down, all these conditions. Dry bulb temperature is 40 degree centigrade, relative humidity 15%. So you can locate these things on the chart very easily if you know all these factors readily.
outlet condition is also mentioned, 25 degrees and 20 degrees centigrade. Now we can locate the point 1 and 2 on the chart according to the given conditions, inlet and outlet conditions. So from the given inlet condition, TD1 equal to 40 degrees centigrade. So where you can record that relative humidity as 15% is given. So from that you can find the additional, so the point 1 is located here. Then next point 2 at 25 degrees centigrade, and wet bulb temperature is 20 degrees centigrade. So from the known given value, you can locate the point 2. From that you can find other remaining the known the unknown terminology here. So what they are asking to find out here, first we will see the step one by one. At 40 degrees centigrade, specific volume you are noting it at point 1, specific volume can note that 0.896 meter cube per kg. So as we have seen in the last previous problems, a number of times it is repeating, mass of air can be found if you know the total volume of air, total volume by that specific volume. So that is 175 by 0.896. So mass of air is given, which is equal to V by Vs1. So mass of air is circulated is 195.31 kg per minute. So process is represented on the chart as 1 to 2. So what is the process here? The temperature is decreasing, moisture content is adding here. So it is cooling and humidification process. Okay. So from the chart at point 2, if you draw the straight horizontal line from the point 2, straight horizontal line which is touching the 100% relative humidity line or the saturation curve. So on that point you can note the dew point temperature TDP2, so which is equal to 17.6 degrees centigrade, and specific humidity at point 1, which is equal to W1 equal to 0.007. so this is the value you can record from the point 1. If you draw the horizontal straight line towards the y ordinate, you can note that W1 equal to 0.007 kg per kg of dry air. Specific humidity at point 2, so this is the value. After plotting the point 2, so if you draw the horizontal straight line towards the y ordinate at this side, W2 equal to 0.0126 kg of dry air. So both the so locating the points and directly get from the chart very easy. What is the W1 value and what is the W2 value? Okay. Next, amount of water vapor added. So it is asking in the question how much amount of water vapor is added. So that you can get if you know the W1 and W2, that is a specific humidity values and mass of air circulated. So thus how you can get from this formula, mass of air into W2 minus W1, so highest minus lowest. So mass of air circulated is 195.31 kg per minute, and the W2 value you know here, and W1 value which are recorded on the psychrometric chart, and finally you are writing here. So the amount of water vapor added here is 1 kg per minute. How much 1.094 kg per minute is adding, amount of water vapor is added here. So this is regarding this problem. This next, we move into the next problem. You can read the question for a while and you can get the, so somewhat it may be a difficult one and a different one also. The stream of outdoor air is mixed with the stream of return air in air that operates at 101 kilopascals pressure, that's at standard atmospheric pressure. Flow rate of outdoor air is 2 kg per second. Flow rate is mentioned here in kg per second, and mostly your kg per minute you are getting, and its condition is 35 degrees centigrade DBT and 25 degrees centigrade WBT. The flow rate of return air is 3 kg per second, and its condition is 24 degrees centigrade and 50% relative humidity. So this is a mixing of air streams are taking place. So determine the enthalpy of the mixture, humidity ratio of the mixture. Enthalpy we have to find out, humidity ratio, and dry bulb temperature of the mixture. So here the
points 1, 2 and 3 are you can see in the chart here, where according to outdoor air, written air and outdoor air and written air, that is a fresh air and written air, mixture of the air stream conditions, as we have seen in the mixing of air streams theory part, the 1-2-2 process you can see here. 1-2-2, the final condition after mixing the air, you are recording at the 0.3 at the exit condition. After air streams are mixed, then you are getting these answers from the 0.3. What is the W3 value and what is the H3 value? Specific humidity and enthalpy at that final condition, and specific humidity at the final condition. So at point 1, so from the given conditions, dry bulb temperature 35 degree centigrade and wet bulb temperature 25 degree centigrade, you are locating the point 1 here. So from that point 1, you can record what is the W1 specific humidity from the chart, the 0.016. What is the enthalpy at point 1, that is H1 equal to, so this is the line you are drawing in the chart. So on the enthalpy scale, you are recording H1 equal to 75.5. Similarly, you will get the point 2 also. The written air, what is the condition? Dry bulb temperature is 24 degree centigrade. So just and the W2 value is 0.00875. So locating this point, you can record what is the H2 value, 48.3. So this we will go one by one. So the 0.3 on the line 1, 2 represents the state point of the resulting mixture. So the 0.3 is indicating mixing of both the air streams, which is coming through the section 1 and 2, mixing at the 0.3. Okay, so from the chart, we have recorded what is the W1 value, 0.016 kg of air, and what is the enthalpy value, 75.5. It is a kilojoules per kg, and W2 value is also recorded as 0.00875 kg per kg of air, and H2 value is 48.3 kilojoules per kg. And also you can see mass of streams, air streams, as mentioned in kg per second. M1 and M2 values are given for fresh air and for written air respectively, that is a 2 kg per second and 3 kg per second. So now, so enthalpy of the mixture, how we can find out? We know this formula, the final condition of the enthalpy, that is H3 equal to, so from the known formula we are writing it as M1 H1 plus M2 H2 by this by M3. M3 is nothing but M1 plus M2. So you know the mass M1 to H1 value is 75.5, so plus 3 into 48.3. So H1 H2 values are taken from the psychrometry chart. M1 M2 equal to 2 plus 3. So finally you are writing that as kilojoules per kg. It is not 59.18 is the answer. So the point again, we have got one enthalpy point there, which is the final state of the mixture at 0.3. Similarly, the humidity ratio of the moisture, so where you are getting noting the point W3 value, that it is equal to M1 W1 plus M2 W2 by M1 plus M2. That finally you are getting it as multiplying all the values, substituting here, you know all those values of W1 and W2, M1 and M2. Substituting, you are getting W3 value as 0.001165 kg per kg of air, that is the W3 value. After locating these two points, W3 and H3 as 0.3 on the line 1 and 2. So finally, the dry bulb temperature of the mixture, so you can plot directly from the chart, or you can get from this formula. You have to use the formula here, where TD3 equal to the same formula again. So M1 TD1 plus M2 TD2 by M1 plus M2. So finally, you are substituting all these values, you know the TD1 and TD2. So finally, you are getting dry bulb temperature of the mixture as 28.4 degree centigrade. So if you observe here, dry bulb temperature at initial stage is 35 and at final stage is 24. And again, it is during its mixture, what happened? The dry bulb temperature may present on the line 1 and 2, so approximately it is 28.4 degree centigrade. That is the mixture of air streams dry bulb temperature value. Okay, so the values of H3, W3 and TD3 we have directly need from the psychrometric chart provided at 0.3 is exactly marked to the scale. So you can cross check with that psychrometry chart again, then you can get that readily. We'll see this is the last one. one more problem. So the atmospheric air, 30 degree centigrade dry bulb temperature and 75% RH, enters the cooling coil, which has a dew point temperature of 14 degree centigrade. So the bypass factor of coil is 0.1. So bypass factor is given, asking to determine the temperature of the air leaving the coil. Okay, sensible heat factor for the process. It's a very important problem. Please try to see. And it is a different problem what we have seen till different cases. Now, right. So coming to the solution here. So locate the point one, which represents the initial condition of air. This is one. From the chart, dew point temperature of entering air is 23 degree centigrade. So this is the dew point temperature. Locate the point one. So it's a 30 degree centigrade dry bulb temperature. 23 degree centigrade is a dew point temperature of the entering air. This is the point one. Since dew point temperature of air is less than the dew point temperature of the coil, so the process is cooling and dehumidification. It should be cooling and dehumidification process. They are drawing the line like this. Okay, next. So temperature of the air leaving the cooling coil. So bypass factor, we have the formula for cooling coil, TD2 minus TD4 by TD1 minus TD4. So where it can be written as TD2 minus TDP4, that is the dew point temperature at the final condition, by TD1 minus TDP4. So finally you are getting the, what is the TD2 value? That is a 15.6 degree centigrade. And the bypass factor already we are given, it is 0.1. So from that we are getting the final condition of that air, the dry bulb temperature is 15.6 degree centigrade. So where, sorry, the temperature of air leaving the coil, okay, that is the final condition of the air, it is 15.6 degree centigrade. So from the point you can record all the things, what is the H1 value, what is the H2 value, what is the intermediate value, you can record it here. That is the HA during the dehumidification process. And so locate the point 2 corresponding to 15.6 degree centigrade and on line 14. Where is the point 2? You can locate here. So that is the air leaving the cooling coil temperature, where it is representing the cooling and dehumidification process. The dry bulb temperature is decreasing as well as the humidification is taking place. So from the chart, H1 equal to 82 kilojoules per kg, HA equal to 52 kilojoules per kg. Sensible heat factor, we have the formula HA minus H2 by H1 minus H2. The substitute all the values are getting it as 0.143. Okay, so this is regarding the today's video session. So mostly we have concentrated on the mixing of air streams and a lot of numerical problems. So hope you'll get more understand if you do a lot of problems on your practice on the psychrometry chart and by using some mathematical relations. And hope you have achieved our objectives. So what are the air streams, how to solve the problems on mixing of air streams and psychrometric processes. So moving on to the quiz here. So in mixing of air streams, the following properties are changed. Coming to the first quiz, what happens when the mixing of air streams are taken place? The properties of following properties are changed. What are those? Mass of air, enthalpy, specific humidity, and all the properties. So what we have seen in the mixing of air streams, different properties like m, enthalpy, h value, and specific humidity, w value. So all the properties may get affected. So answer you are getting it as the final one as d. Then coming to the next quiz question, the following law is satisfied in mixing of air streams. It is a conservation of mass, conservation of energy, a and b, and none of the above. So answer is both. So we have seen the two different two different equations regarding the mass and regarding the energy equation. So both the answers A and B, both are satisfied in mixing of the air streams. Next, moving into the frequently asked questions. So explain the mixing of air streams. with the help of psychrometric chart. So this is a question what you have seen for first one, how the mixing of air streams are taking place. We have seen the process and we have represented the same thing on the chart also. Next, we'll see the question. A stream of 200 meter cube of outdoor air with 40 degree centigrade dry bulb temperature and 45% RH is adiabatically mixed with 300 meter cube of recirculated air at 24 degree centigrade DBT and 60% RH. So find dry bulb temperature of the resulting mixture. So kindly you can note this question. Then you can solve this on your own and with the help of the psychrometric chart or using some formulas, you can find it very easily. This is also mixing of air streams problem. So try to note it down and you can solve it. This is maybe a frequently asked question in the examination. So whatever the problems we have practiced, please try to solve them. Okay. Next question, atmospheric air at 30 degree centigrade, dry bulb temperature and 75% RH, relative humidity, enters the cooling coil at the rate of 200 meter cube per minute. The cooling coil given temperature 14 degree centigrade and bypass factor for the coil is 0.1. Determine the temperature of the air leaving the coil and the capacity of the cooling coil in terms of refrigeration, amount of water vapor removed per minute and sensible heat factor of the process. And so please try to make a note of this frequently this question. It is also very important. So a lot of things they have asked here. What is the temperature of the air leaving the coil, capacity of the cooling coil, not the casting coil here, it's a cooling coil, in terms of refrigeration, amount of water vapor removed per minute and sensible heat factor of the process. Next question, atmospheric air at 20 degree centigrade and 60% RH is heated and humidified in such a way that the final DBT is 30 degree centigrade and RH is 50%. So determine the heat and moisture rate, determine the heat added or heat removed, moisture added to the air per minute if the volume entering air is 100 meter cube per minute. So you can note for a while, just you can note it down the question. So this is also one frequently asked question. So please try to make it solve. Already we have seen these type of questions, already we have solved in the problems. Next question, you can note it down. That's the outside air 31 degree centigrade DBT and 18.5 degree centigrade DBT enters the cooling coil at the rate of 40 meter cube per minute. Effective surface temperature of the coil is 4.5 degree centigrade and its cooling capacity is 12.5 kilowatts of the refrigeration. Continuation, what they are asking to find out. So capacity of the refrigeration is given as 12.5 kilowatts. So find WBT, DBT of the air leaving the coil, enthalpy of air leaving the coil and bypass factor of the coil. So three things, DBT and WBT, enthalpy of air leaving the coil and bypass factor of the coil. It's also one frequently asked question. So please make a note of this question. Next question, we'll see one assignment question here. So this is the assignment question. You can take it, note it down the question. Please try to write this question and please try to make as an assignment and note it down and do the solution for this case.
we have written this question and you can solve it. So we have done this problem bypass factor, already we have seen this, and how to find the capacity of cooling coil. I think we have seen that question in the what we have solved solved questions are there. This is assignment for you, and make a note and do that solution. And the continuation capacity of the humidifier also. Next question, 30 meter cube per minute of moisture at 15 degree centigrade DVT and 13 degree centigrade WPT is the initial conditions of air. So that is it's mixed with 12 meter cube per minute at 25 degree centigrade DVT and 50% RH. So determine dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature of the resulting mixture. It's very, very, very easy question, and solve it very easily. Mixing of two air streams. Please try to make a note and do this assignment question. Very easy, you can solve it. Okay, so this is regarding
This is regarding the complete theory class regarding the mixing of air streams and the numerical problems. So hope we have done number of numerical problems and we have seen how to solve them very easily. If you have the chart and you locate the points, just whatever the things I have told, you please try to remember those points. If you know the two, if you know the two factors in the psychrometric chart, you can find out the remaining all other factors very easily. Just to try to remember that minimum things see, and also I told to analyze before doing the solution. Please try to make analyze in the examination. So under what category how the problem can be solved, with the help of the chart or without help of the chart. We have to use any mathematical equations and look at what type of problem it is. For example, if it is regarding to mixing of air streams, or it is regarding to the psychrometric processes, or it is regarding to some psychrometric terms, terminology. So make a difference of them and try to solve the problems. You can do it very easily. This psychrometric chart will be very helpful in your at any time when you move into higher studies also. Just when this chapter is getting like air conditioning, psychrometry is very, very, very useful for you for moving into some advanced topics. These basics are very important. So hope you have got some information regarding the psychrometry chapter. Okay, and lot of things we have learned in this psychrometry. So hope this is very easy and you can understood it very easily. Try to watch all the videos of the psychrometry, then you can get some information and further you can proceed for the next remaining chapters. So hope you have understood, and thank you for watching, and we'll meet in the next video sessions with the different chapters in this refrigeration. What are the left topics like moving into the next stages of air conditioning, different applications of air conditioning are there, and we will see that. So thank you for watching, and we'll meet in the next video session. Thank you.